a message for all motorists travelling on the M1 to Swansea.
Get off! It doesn't go to Swansea.
Funny folk, it's Ken Dodd's Comic Cuts.
Now listen, intellectuals, now everywhere, intellectuals, do you want an IQ of over 160 or more? I mean, would you like to earn 10,000 a year or more? Do you? Well, I can tell you, you won't get it sitting around here listening to this rubbish all night.
Meet the barniest brain in Britain, Ken Dodd.
For filling your doctor's trousers with chestnuts, standing him in front of a roaring fire and saying, "Now, you cough." What a beautiful day for buying your granddad a dictionary so he can lie in the front garden and look up skirts.
Doctor, doctor.
Yes, what is it?
Oh, doctor, just look at my face.
Hmm. What about it, hmm?
Oh, handsome devil, aren't I?
Yes. What are you doing after surgery?
Meanwhile, in ancient Greece, it's ancient Archimedes bath time.
Ah! Oh, Eureka!
You what?
I've got it.
Got what?
A rubber duck. I've been looking for it all over.
And brains. That's what the show's all about this week, folks. Brains, you see. Antonio, the great flamenco dancer. There was a genius for you. He used to travel the world dancing the fandango with his fan in one hand and his dango in the other. He did once perform before royalty. He ran on the pitch at the cup final.
The way you think reflects in your attitude to life. By thinking positively, you can become a new man. For instance, when you get up in the morning, think pleasant thoughts.
Oh, Raquel. Oh, yes, please, Raquel. Yes. I'd love another donut.
When you look in the shaving mirror, give yourself a boost.
Hi there, gorgeous. Ah, you're looking good.
Oh, you mean, moody, magnificent hulk of masculinity. Look at that noble, handsome face.
On your way to work, throw your shoulders back, chin in the air, and stride purposefully forward.
Ah, oh, what a beautiful day. Good morning, Mr. Sun. Good morning, trees. Good morning, pillarbox. Good morning, grass.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, constable. Good morning, pansies.
I think you better come along with me, sir.
Finally, when you get to work, walk in with a huge grin on your face. Think happy thoughts. Radiate brightness and joy and laugh and the world laughs with you.
Good morning, good morning, one and all. Hey, whoop the workers.
Good morning, my lord. The court will rise.
Oh, yes. Proceed to the first case.
Some people turn their brains to criminal endeavors, only to find that they're in for a surprise.
Are you right, Gladys? Right, Ethel? But there's nobody looking. Stick those groceries in your bag, quick.
Yeah. Excuse me, madam.
What do you want?
I think you put some tins in your bag without paying for them. Yes, I thought so. Yeah, I think the manager'd like a word with you.
I'm the manager. Congratulations, Mrs. You're our millionth shoplifter. Have this bouquet of flowers.
And now it's over to a place renowned for logical discussion and sensible debate, where tempers never fray and everyone sees the other fellow's point of view.
Well, it can't be the House of Commons.
No, it's the tap room of the Eagle and Child.
Well, Wellington boots and all the rest of it is very
the
funny.
Kids of today have not got the brains that they were born with.
Oh, rubbish, 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 Hector. There's nothing wrong with today's youth.
No, well, look at Stanley here. I mean, if he had brains, he'd be dangerous.
There's nothing wrong with Stanley, is there, lad?
Well, no, and I'll tell you something else. Here, now, talking about brains,
There's a chap at the end of our street who has more brains than anyone in this pub.
Oh, yes, right. Who is he?
He's a butcher. He got sheep's brains, cow's brains.
You see what I'm... This is what I'm on about. Is this the future Britain has to look forward to?
You can't judge everybody by Stanley.
When I was a lad, we didn't have the chances these layabouts have today. Do you know, I had to leave school at 12.
I left school at 4.
You left school at 4? Why? Why?
Because if I left at 5 past, I'd have missed the bus home.
Shut up. You see what I mean?
I'll prove you wrong.
I'll bet you drinks all round that you cannot find me one smart kid today.
Right. Hector, you're on. Right, where shall I start? I know. I'll ask this little lad playing in the street. Excuse me, sonny, what would you say if someone said you were watching too much television?
I would say, exterminate them! Exterminate them! Slubber-dub, slubber-dub! Bee!
Go on, you little creep! Ah, this looks more like it, a Boy Scout. Hello, Sunshine, what are you doing?
Oh, sir, I'm practicing tying a bandage. It's the first lesson of my first aid course. Can I practice on you, sir?
Well, so why not? You're an intelligent enough lad.
Thank you, sir. You see, you wrap it round here, sir.
Round here?
Yes, round here. Across here.
Yes, I do.
Behind here.
Yes.
Up here.
Now, oops, watch it.
Sorry, sir. And I'll just put this splint here, sir.
Thank you.
And I'll tie this knot here and yes, this yes. knot here, sir.
Hang on. You're choking me. I'm covered in bandages. I can't breathe. How do you get these things off?
Well, how should I know, sir? That comes in the second lesson.
When's that?
Next month, sir. So cheerio, sir.
It's the Hell's Angels, and me trussed up like a turkey.
Oh, hey, look, lads. Old Tutankhamun's escaped from his esophagus. Here, hang on, mate. We'll soon have you out.
Thanks a lot, lads. Oh, you Hell's Angels. You aren't as bad as they make you out, you know.
Oh, that's right, mate. Well, people think we're just a load of fit fags, but we ain't, is we, lads, what?
No, that's right.
Now, take this lad here, for instance. Yeah. Herbert. Now, yeah. Otherwise known as the mad saber-tooth ripper of the 14th chapter. He's brilliant, ain't you, Herb, eh?
Oh, yes.
Yeah. He knows the answers to everything you can ask him. He's a genius. Now, listen to this. Here, Herb, where do you get milk from? Now, listen to him, listen to him.
Oh, yeah, you get... Where you get milk from, where milk out.
Oh,
you know, I should enter him for mastermind if I were you.
Oh, you must admit, he has it up there.
Oh, he has it down here too.
I think he's got it all up there, if you ask me.
Yeah, well, we got to be going now, mate. Our Herb here has got to go to night classes now.
What, you mean he's a student of further education?
Ah, turn it up, mate. He ain't no student. He's a teacher. See ya.
Ciao. Oh, well, it takes all sorts. Ah, let's find out what the older generation thinks. Excuse me, Gaffer.
Yes, young man.
What do you think about the young generation? Are they as clever as they were in your day?
Yeah, well, I don't really know.
Why not?
I walked out of school on Pancake Tuesday, 1906, and I've never been back.
Good gracious me.
Oh, excuse me, gentlemen. I couldn't help overhearing your conversation. I think you must agree that we children of today are much more intelligent than in your day. If you don't mind me saying so, sir.
Well, no, not at all, my fine little fellow. In fact, look, I'll ask you and this gentleman a little poser now to see who gets it right.
Yes.
Now, if it takes a week to walk a fortnight in 2 days,
yes.
How long will it take a flea to walk across a barrel of treacle with clogs on? Hmm?
Yeah, come on. Right, what's the answer?
A double-decker bus.
A double-decker bus? How does that come out?
On 4 wheels.
There you are, Thompson Maynard. I've been looking for you. Yeah, run away from school, would you?
Oh, now you're for it, sonny.
No, it's not him he wants, but it's me. 68 years I've been looking for you, you little whippersnapper. Now come with me. You get 6 of the best. Take that,
Mr. Upchop. Oh, from here, Mr. Upchop.
Good. I wondered why he was wearing short trousers. You come with me, sonny. Come on.
What did I tell you? I mean, there's no sign of clever clogs, so I win my bet.
Oh, no, you don't, Hector. This little lad is so smart. This little boy, he can answer any question you like to put to him.
Well, he can he? Right. Well, we'll soon see. Now, listen, lad.
Who won the FA Cup in 1922?
Go on, tell me that.
Huddersfield Town won it by 1-0. The scorer was Smith and the referee wore odd bootlaces. Oh, yes. And a black and white spaniel called Charlie ran onto the pitch in the 63rd minute.
Listen, now look, I have just bought a 1964 Cortina. How much is it worth?
Your 1964 concertina is worth about £10, I should say.
That is where you're wrong, because I bought one today, and I paid £250 for it. And what is more, I mean, you can't even talk properly. It is not a concertina.
Oh, yes, it is.
You tell him, lad.
You see, I just bumped it with me chopper bike.
You what?
And it rolled downhill.
No.
And it hit the wall at the back of the gasworks.
So you see, it is a concertina, and it's worth about a tenner.
I mean, I'm burning it.
We'll get the drinks in first. I won again.
I found you just in time. You brought meaning to this life of mine and made a broken heart a valentine. At last my lonely hours are all behind. You kissed me just in time to fill the longing in these lips of mine. Just when I thought the sun would never shine, I found you just in time. Just in time to save my world. Heaven sent an angel to my door. Just in time her arms reached out and held me close and let me love once more. Don't let me cry again. Don't ever let me hear goodbye again. 'Cause baby, when I almost lost my mind, I found you just in time. I found you just in time. You brought meaning to this life of mine and made a broken heart a valentine. At last my lonely hours are all behind. Don't make me cry again. Don't ever let me hear goodbye again. 'Cause baby, when I almost lost my mind, I found you just in
that infamous seat of learning, Naughty Ash University, for another little squirt at the fountain of knowledge from that madcap mastermind, Professor Rufus Chakrabarty.
So you see, students, my brain is protected by my skull.
You mean your cranium?
No, I'm as English as the rest of you.
Do you believe in auto-suggestion, Professor?
Ah, yes, indeed. If I want to get up at 8 o'clock in the morning, I just bang my head on the pillow and say, I will get up at 8 o'clock. I will get up at 8 o'clock. And when it's 8 o'clock, I get up with no trouble at all.
Mm-hmm. How long do you bang your head on the pillow?
Till 8 o'clock in the morning. Oh, yeah. Now, the Russian psychologist, Pavlov experimented with dogs.
Oh, Akhavi, the filthy devil.
In our brains, we all have conflicts. I put milk on mine for breakfast.
Professor, what about all those psychopaths?
People shouldn't ride their bikes on the pavements.
Professor, I love men's toes. What would you call this?
It's a fetish.
Professor, I'm up 1 minute and down the next.
What's your job?
I'm a lift operator.
Professor, can people be conditioned?
Yes, take a Bob Martin's every night.
Just suppose.
Supposing I should fall in love with you.
Just suppose drunk was sober.
How do you mean?
Well, imagine what it would be like if everybody was sloshed all the time and went out to get sober.
In what way?
Imagine a magistrate's court.
Be upstanding, for the drunk is the Lord Chief of Justice. Oh,
Silence, will you? Bring forth the first case. No, you better make it two cases. Really short. Oh, dear. I must say, he looks a very suspicious character. The sort of ne'er-do-well who frequents coffee bars and temperance socials and other sober institutions. I find him guilty. Hang him.
Guilty? Guilty? But you haven't tried me yet.
What's the evidence, Constable?
Well, what's it? I was staggering up the high street in a north, south, east, and westerly direction.
Good lad.
With the prisoner drove fast in the second gear.
Second gear?
Second gear. At 28 miles an hour.
Oh.
In a straight line.
Pardon me.
Stopped at the zebra crossing and led an old lady across.
Disgraceful. Do you breathalyze him?
I breathalyzed him. I recognized him. I recognized him at the Christmas. Didn't go green.
Not even after four times?
Not after four times. I then took him back to the station.
Fair enough.
Where he couldn't walk. Where he couldn't walk the crooked line properly.
That's terrible! I sentence you to report to the leaf. The Rose and Crown every night at opening time to get thoroughly plastered. Here, hang on. We'll come with you.
Right, old Doddy. Come on now, boy O'Bach. I've had enough of you. You're driving me crackers, so I'm challenging you to a duel.
You are?
Yes, I am that. What would you say to hedgehogs at 50 paces?
Nothing at all. They wouldn't be able to hear me.
Did you know that women who make night dresses are called shift workers?
Did you know that the Duke of Wellington was a man of high esteem? He used to come out of the top of his helmet like a kettle.
Did you know that the world's silliest haberdasher put zips on flies and buttons on blue bottles?
Did you know that the most hard-faced man in the world was an Aberdeen man who used to rehearse the charge, then make an obscene telephone call?
Did you know that Albert Einstein would never have discovered the theory of relativity if it hadn't been for the fact that he was clever? And who gave me that one?
Here is the weather forecast. It will be mostly dry with a few scattered showers.
And now, here is the long-range weather forecast.
It will be mostly dry with a few scattered showers!
Meanwhile, back in the Kremlin...
Well, Vladimir, how went your trip to decadent bourgeois Britain, huh?
Most instructive, comrade Ivan. I went to a typical decadent capitalist entertainment, the badminton horse trials.
Ah, and what happened?
They were all found guilty.
Now, what are we going to do for the last sketch?
Oh, I don't think we've got one.
We've got to have one. It's in the BBC charter. All radio shows must have a last sketch. Now, come on, let's have some ideas.
I know. Let's do something that's never been done before.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, a skit on cold dips, where it turns out they're escaping from a holiday camp.
I know, let's do one about Frankenstein.
Oh, yes. And Bagsy be the wench in the village pub.
Yes.
You know, the one who the monster carries off and has his wicked way with.
Oh. Is there any one snag? I mean, where are we going to get all the corpses from?
Well, there's a couple here on the front road. Don't look as though they'll be with us. Don't look as though they'll be with us much longer.
Yeah, but look, this is ridiculous. I mean, we can't have Frankenstein making a comeback after all these years.
Why not? Frank Sinatra keeps doing it. We could have Dracula as a BBC linkman.
Yes. Committing atrocities on sausages.
We need a good title for the sketch. Now, how about Appointment with Fear?
I had an appointment with fear once.
Oh, what happened?
Nothing. I turned up an hour late.
I can see it all now.
Oh, you shouldn't be looking.
We'll do a sketch about Frankenstein and the monster. Our story opens in Transylvania, Baron Frankenstein's castle. It's grim Gothic piles. Swathed in ghostly fog, vampires and bloodthirsty bats fly about willy-nilly.
Willy-nilly! 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 Willy-nilly!
Willy-nilly! Oh, master!
It's the wind howling, Igor.
Oh, I see.
Igor, my friend, go to the laboratory.
Oh, but master, I've just been.
Oh, numbskull! Go and prepare the electrodes.
Yes, master. Oh, my neck.
Here, you. I want a word with you.
Oh, hello, dearest wife.
And don't you flannel me. I suppose you're going to be at it again tonight in that dungeon of yours, sticking arms and legs and whatnots together, making your stupid monster. Why can't you get a flipping jigsaw like anyone else?
But my darling wifey, when my magnificent creation comes to life, he will be of great service to you about the house.
What good will he be?
Well, he can answer the door when the rent man comes, frighten the life out of him. He can get the dinner ready, he can jump up and down on some boiled spuds doing the monster mash. Anyway, he'll be company for you when I go away on business.
Like heck he will. I'm not sitting in this house alone with that thing roaming about.
Master, yes.
You want to take
touch some of the onions. Master, there is a man without, and he's brought a salami sausage.
Oh, good. That'll be the part I'm waiting for, to complete the monster, the missing link. Let us go into the laboratory. Igor, my friend, we stand on the threshold of man's greatest ever scientific achievement. I shall now turn this knob.
That should bring tears to his eyes.
Wireless.
Oh, sorry, master.
Now, the temperature must be constant. The smallest draft could upset the delicate electrical balance of the sensitive apparatus.
Yes, master.
I shall now throw the switch that will transmit the flash of lightning into a surge of electrical power to raise the monster. To rouse the monster, I'm sorry.
Raise him? Oh, that'll make him sit up and take notice.
The time is right. I will throw the switch now! Oh. Igor, the door is open. The cold night air will ruin everything. Wait, my monster stirs.
Yes.
His eyes are flickering. Oh, he lives. Dear, dear. At last, the monster speaks.
Oh, shut that door.
Oh, well. Happy bye! Happy bye!
Was Clem Dodd's Comic Cuts. This week we've been examining the various ways of exercising your faculties. In this psychedelic brains trust, John Baddeley pontificated frequently, Joe Manning Wilson invented excuses, Miriam Margolyes proved it once and for all, Delphin Thomas surpassed himself, and Michael McLean collected the empties. The absent-minded professor was Ken Dodd, who kept on forgetting himself. The show was devised and compiled by Ken Dodd, with additional material by Morris Bird, Dave Dutton, Dennis Burson, and Terry Ravenscroft. We put in a request for a producer, and the Labour Exchange sent us Bobby J.